Defend yourselves at all times. Now shake hands and come out of the bell.
So I'll tell you early on that Marrone, yes, indeed, he's been involved in head clashes. He has a technical draw because of a head clash, and he was cut over his right eye in his career.
Remember, fought in May 2009, then had a three-round knockout in September of 2012. That's it. Those three rounds between now and going back to 2009.
See, I'm so glad that you touched on that because that might be the most important part of the fight. Just like we talked in the Colt feature about Diaz being vulnerable early to Vincente because of his inactivity, same thing here. There's a danger zone early for Marrone because of that inactivity. And you touched on it. Plenty of gaps of that inactivity in his career. Like you said, 9 months since he was last in the ring. But then, before that fight, he was off 3 years and 4 months. Also, he has gaps of 2 years and 1 month and 1 year and 4 months. So, lots of gaps. Danger zone, maybe early on. And Payano wants to jump on him a little bit. But that's really not Payano's way. He likes to give a little ground and look to counter for the most part.
He just did with a left hand.
Talk about amateur experience. How about 523 amateur fights for Payano? Two Olympics represented Dominican Republic in 2004 and 2008.
Those are the kind of numbers when you start talking 500 plus that we would see with a Cuban amateur or an old era Soviet or Iron Curtain laden amateur.
Very good point.
Because they didn't have the option of turning pro.
No, they didn't. They didn't have professional boxing and those regimes, those countries that a lot of them would...
Laswell Papp.
Exactly.
1950s.
Dictatorship, communist countries back
Tao
in those
Stevenson.
Days. Yes, exactly. They could not turn pro unless, of course, they escaped, got out of there, came to the United States. Otherwise, they could not turn pro, and you'd see them in 2-3 Olympics. And you'd accumulate, as you just said, many, many amateur fights. Maybe too many sometimes. Sometimes you can get burnt out in the amateurs with that many fights. A lot of miles on the odometer.
Payano doing Marrone a favor here based on what we were talking about? There's blood coming from the corner of his right eye.
Yeah, I think he is because that inactivity of Marrone, you know, he's rusty early, maybe a little doubtful early. You get on him, take advantage of it. You can't take advantage of it if you're staying away. And there's a cut in the corner of the right eye of Payano. Payano was cut over his right eye 4 fights ago, and he's cut there again.
We'll get confirmation from the commission here ringside as to whether that was confirmed as a clash of heads or caused by a punch.
The referee has said the cut was from a punch. We disagree. The pictures tell us right here that there's a clash of heads. Watch right here, you're gonna see the heads come together right in that spot where the blood is, where the cut is, in the corner of the right eye of Payano. This might be a good time for boxing to use replay.
You know, interestingly enough, and good job by the alternate referee sitting ringside here, because Sparkle Lee, Randy Newman first said, you know, it was a punch. Sparkle Lee said, I saw it as a clash. She gave him some counsel. And I believe we'll get clarification with the ringside commission, but I think they're probably going to go with that being a clash of heads based on what they saw ringside here.
Yeah, why wouldn't you? I mean, you have the technology, you have the benefit of seeing it.
And you got one of your colleagues sitting right here.
Yeah, and she saw it, and you don't have to guess at it. You know, guess that it was a punch, guess that it was a head. No, you look at the replay, it's available to you, it's a clash, get it right. So hopefully they do get it right, that it was a clash of heads. We said before the fight started, in the first round, that Marrone has been involved, and you could see why. Joey comes in there, he leans forward, his upper body gets ahead of his lower body. That's a no-no. That's the wrong way to do it. You're supposed to have your legs up there and have your upper body with your legs, not ahead of your legs. And Marrone's been involved in head clashes before.
Hey.
And because of that style, because of that flaw in his technique. Yeah, Bernardo over, I see him over talking to the commission at ringside trying to get clarification about headbutt or punch. But right now, Mayano, the busier man, and again, doing it his way. He gives a little to get a little, gives a little ground, gets you to reach in a little bit, and does that. Counters you. Cutman didn't do a great job in the corner there. The right eye of Mayano dripping already.
Dr. Richard Hill working that corner. Mickey Ward is the assistant in that corner, Herman Macedo.
Well, Mickey was good at creating cuts. I don't know if he's that great at closing them, but hopefully the doctor will do a better job. So there's the counterpunching. I mean, that is the perfect example of pure counterpunching. Mayano waited for the wide punch from Marrone, and it was wide from too far away. Mayano made him miss and then made him pay. And that's what Mayano's all about. You know, he's got good eyes. He sees it coming. He's got a good field of vision. Just look at him. He's concentrating really with those peepers, looking for spots. If you wait too long on him, you're a little slow. He'll beat you to the mark. But otherwise, he waits for that. Wait for you to miss, and then he's going to look to come back with something.
Reminder, you can head over to our Facebook page and join in the live scoring with Teddy Atlas. Kendall Holt sitting ringside here for Friday Night Fights. Of course, we saw him in a big spot earlier this year. You know, one of the all-time greats. Talking about Olympic glory, 1984 gold, Meldrick Taylor. 1990, that classic with Julio Cesar Chavez with 2 seconds left in the 12th round.
Yeah, Taylor winning the fight, but taking a lot of punishment down the stretch. So game, Philadelphia fighter. And then, as you said, Chavez stopping him. The referee, Richard Steele, deciding to stop it. And a lot of controversy about that stoppage. 2 seconds before the end.
Is he ahead on two or three scorecards, if I recall? Classic showdown.
Looks like a reversal of roles for a second early here. Don't know who's who. Marrone, usually the guy walking in a little crude, sometimes a little wide, and a little available sometimes, but Mayano, the guy giving ground, counterboxing, counterpunching. Marrone now comes out doing a little boxing. All of a sudden, it's Marrone looking for spots. Making a little adjustment. One of the adjustments for Marrone, Joe, should be go to the body. Mayano, you have a guy using his legs, a guy who's a little bit tricky defensively. Go downstairs. Both southpaws here, as we talked about in the fight plan. So usually a southpaw has an edge going into a fight because the orthodox fighter doesn't usually see southpaws that much. The edge is negated here. Both guys looking into a mirror.
Teddy, last round you saw Bernardo, the news hound over there with the commission. Let's see what he came up with. Bernardo.
Joe, Randy Newman, after the end of round one, told Commissioner Aaron Davis it was a punch that caused the cut. Then, after the advice of the auxiliary referee Sparkle Lee, he walked over after the end of the second round and told the commissioner it's now by an accidental headbutt. So that changes the situation immensely.
Okay, so it's officially going down, according to the commissioner, as a clash of heads, the cut over the right eye. Listen, here's all I care about. I don't care about
get it right.
The rules. Just get it right. And they did.
And use the information, use the equipment, in this case, the videotape, to get it right. Right now, the big advantage, forget about counterpunching, the advantage for me in this fight right now is Mayano a little quicker, and he's still bleeding in the corner of that right eye, but a little quicker with his feet and with his hands. Marrone, a little cement-footed, a little on the slow side.
Coming to the end of round three, these two unbeaten bantamweights clashing here in West Orange, New Jersey.
He's hurt.
Stabbing left hand and then a sweeping right hand to the body, and he scores the knockdown there in the final seconds of round number three.
And guess what? Exactly what we talked about in the fight plan.
Bell rang, right?
Payano slid out a little bit. He likes to slide out, look for that left uppercut.
Cuidate, okay?
And he gave a little space with the right hand down. And Marrone filled that space with the straight left hand. Watch.
There it is.
Exactly what we talked about in the fight plan. Marrone, right hand down. I should say Payano leans over on that side.
Stayed right in the path of it.
Exactly. The straight left hand did the job. And there it is. Full extension. Good extension by Marrone on his power punch. The left hand. We talked in the fight plan. Both fighters like their left hand. Marrone loves it to the head. Well, he's got to be happy right now.
So Juan Carlos Payano hurt and goes down in the final seconds there of round three.
So now Payano has two things to worry about. Having just been dropped and having a cut that has not been completely handled in the corner by Dr. Richard Hill.
Now Jundy Marrone. See if he can come out and take advantage here. Oh, there's a sharp left hand by Payano. And now he's on the attack.
Well, Payano's still the quicker guy, feet and hands. So far, just one spot that has damaged him by Marrone. But look for that left hand. That's what is the calling card for Marrone. That left hand to the head. And look for the opportunity for it when Payano slips over to his left and gives a little too much space and keeps the right hand low.
Right.
See, I like a guy if he's going to slip over. Just imagine this at home, you guys. If Payano's going to slip to his left, be close where there's no space. And then you can punch back, and then Marrone has to be... He has to be worried about something coming back. He's got to be defensive-minded. But if you slip, if you're Payano and you slip over to your left side, there's space. You're just hanging out there in the space. You're giving a wide-open alley to get caught by Marrone. See, if you slip something, you're close, but there's no space to do anything. Right now, pretty simple. Payano getting off first. And again, a little quicker. Payano does it two ways, Joe. You know, he'll counter, he'll give him ground, he'll get the counter. A little warning here by the ref. He'll counter a little bit. But he'll also beat you to the mark if you're slow, if you're laying there. Especially if you're not using a jab. And Marrone, no jab, just laying there. There's a little setup there, a little low bend, and then, you know, jack in the box.
That little right hook there. Let's see the impact that that knockdown had on the scorecards. Teddy 10-8 round makes it 28-28. Of course, you, the fan at home, can score along on Facebook. And we go by percentage of voting. Obviously, Marrone with the knockdown, getting that round doesn't show the 10-8 round, but two rounds to one would have the same score as Teddy.
Referee doesn't want to lose control of this fight here. He's got to stay not in the action. You want to be out of the action, but close enough to get in there quickly if you need to be.
Right.
So there's that low bend there. Low bend, it's a setup. It's to mesmerize Marrone, get him looking at the bend, and then come out again out of that jack-in-the-box and catch him. If I'm in the corner of Marrone, I'm saying, let's take advantage of that. When he's bending low, he can't do anything. Let's catch him on his way up. Let's not just look at him.
Listening into the corner, that's brought to you by the U.S. Marine Corps. Bernardo's translating for us.
Oíste?
Do you hear me?
He's
landing the hook under, on the body.
Okay.
Take a step back. Stay away from his straight right. That's the one he's talking with.
Okay.
I would disagree with that.
That was the straight left he
straight
dropped
left,
him with.
Yes.
Obviously, southpaws here, and it was the straight left as he dipped out to his left-hand side and stayed in the path of the punch.
Hey, that's a bad sign when the corner's giving you wrong information, right? I mean,
they're used to fighting orthodox fighters, right? So they say straight right, so straight left. Yeah.
Go down the road a piece.
Right.
About 20 miles later. Where is this place?
Exactly.
I'd like to know if it's a left or right from my corner. If I'm in the ring and I'm doing
something. Costello in the corner.
Yeah, exactly. Who's on first?
Right, on
I'm doing something as difficult as boxing. Darn right. I want to know, is it a left or a right?
Oh.
I think Marone, their corner should be concentrating on that move, that bend of Piano. You know, he bends, tries to surprise you, gets you captured looking at the bend, and then he comes up and tries to catch you with something where you're kind of mesmerized by looking at what the heck's this guy doing bending so low. But Marone's seen it twice already. If I'm in the corner, I'm telling him, you see that again, you catch him when he's susceptible. He's bending like that. He can't do anything until he gets up. Catch him on the way up.
You can time that.
Exactly, Joe. See, the thing that's hurting Marone really bad, you know, I've pretty much documented, and you can see with your eyes, that Piano's quicker. Puts punches together a little better, a little bit fleeter on his feet. But Marone is allowing him to be quicker by not jabbing. He's really playing into the strengths of Piano, because look at Marone, he's just standing there like a heavy bag. He's not using his jab to take some of this play away from Piano. You have to use your jab. You can't wait and think about it. While you're waiting and thinking about it, you get beat to the mark like that.
There it is.
You gotta use your jab. There's just a little trip in there. You gotta use your jab to put bugs on the windshield, like I like to say a lot of times. In other words, block the view of the guy in front of you. You know, don't allow Piano to have such a good view. He's got a good view right now.
Yeah, he just had a three-punch combination that time. Right jab, the straight left, and then the right hook. Now he gets off a 1-2. Right hand straight low there. Teddy talk of blinding with the jab. Bugs on the windshield.
And that's really what they need to do. There's the low bed again, and Marone does not take advantage.
Take a step in and fire away. See if you can time it.
Exactly. And he should be aware of it. That's the third time this tonight it's happened. Corner needs to do a better job with making their man aware of that and ready for that.
Tonight's foolproof crunch of the night, Teddy, brought to you by Just for Men, Yanifel Vicente.
And there you see it, the right uppercut by Vincente, and you see the opening because of that wide left hook by Diaz. Need to be taught not to throw a wide hook in front of your man, otherwise you get caught with a right hand. That time, a right uppercut.
Get some new information concerning what happened with that cut over the right eye in round number one. Bernardo, what can you offer?
Joe, they acknowledge that the TV replay showed that it was a headbutt, but the rules here in New Jersey don't allow for replay. Therefore, they're going to go with the original call from referee Randy Newman. There is a process of appeal in case it becomes an issue here in this fight. But as of now, it's back to a punch that caused the cut on Payani.
I love bureaucracy.
Why make things complicated?
Don't you love bureaucracy, Teddy?
Just get it right. You see it. You see what it is. Just do it. Just get it right. Use common sense.
Oh, Teddy, not in the day and age of over-officious bureaucracy. Why have that?
You're right. It's a shame. Right now, it's a shame that Marone isn't using the jab because he's behind on the scorecards, at least on mine, because he's not. Yeah, there's that low bend. Not quite as much, but Piano, when he's low, he's handcuffing himself a little bit. Marone should be letting those hands fly. See, no jab by Marone, so he gets beat to the mark. If the jab was coming from Marone, Piano has to go defensive instead of offensive. That's the key to the jab. When you're fighting a guy like Piano, he's moving a little bit.
And right on target, the guys at Copy Box offer up the total jabs on the punch stats. Piano throwing 172 to Marone's 104, only landing 9 is the Philippine.
Talking about Philippines, 15 of Marone. 16 fights have been in the Philippines. This is his second fight in the United States, and most of the fights for Payano have been in the Dominican Republic and Florida. So the guy used to fighting in the United States more is Payano. This is a step up for both guys tonight, you know, Joe. Both of these guys have been fed a lot of soft competition getting to this point. So
I wish more guys would do this. I wish we saw more 13-0 versus 15-0-1. It's good for the sport.
Watch what I've been talking about. Watch here as Payano bends really low. And what is Marrone doing? Nothing. Watch, real low. Right there, there's an opportunity. I'd say about a split second, and that's a lot of time in boxing, to get off while he's down. Because when he's down low like that, he's basically vulnerable. He's handcuffed. He can't do anything till he gets up. And you could see that opportunity for Marrone, it passed by the wayside.
Payano opens up the seventh here with a left hook. You know, it's funny because Marrone's body language, almost it acts as if Payano, you know, threw a feint there. He actually, his body goes back for a moment, just the opposite of what you're looking for him to do. Here's a good offensive attack and a knockdown scored by Juan Carlos Payano.
6-7-8, that's it, let's go.
Good night. Marrone, first loss of his career. Payano stays unbeaten. And still down on the canvas is 28-year-old Jundy Marrone, as they have four ringside positions here, does the New Jersey Commission. So they are well staffed to handle this situation. And they are tending to him there on the ring apron. See him moving his eyes as they were just talking to Jundy Marrone.
Yeah, he's conscious, he's alert. Right now, just at home for the concerned viewers, the medical people are doing their job. They're keeping Marrone stable. Don't want him to move yet. They're asking him questions, asking him if he feels his extremities, if he's cognizant of what's going on. And then when they feel they've gotten the right answers and they've seen what they want to see, then they will get him up to the stool. But right now, the medical people are doing their job.
Teddy, the one thing that we can say through all the years of handling situations like this is that the ringside physicians will take their time in this process. They want medical attention immediately, but they are slow in their approaches, how they go about the process of handling the fallen fighter. And they look for certain things, and most ringside physicians are trained, especially equipped to handle this from a neurological standpoint. So you won't see them quickly get him to the stool until they feel good enough to do so. They look for movement in the extremities. They hand, and this is a good sign. Yeah, this is when they feel good enough where he can handle them being moved to the stool. They'll get him to the stool, and then EMTs will often enter the ring and take it from there.
You know, they did it step by step, followed the procedure, the process, if you will, kept them stable. Didn't let them move until they got the answers, until they saw what they needed to see. They saw, they heard, and now they have him up on the stool, and it's a good sight to see. And now we can talk about how Payano put him in that position. He did it with the left hand. We talked to the fight plan. Both these fighters like to use the left hand. Well, the left hand of Payano was the one that got it done.
Let's show you how he accomplished it. It was impressive.
And why does a punch land? Because an opportunity is given. There you saw Marrone laying on his left side, just laying there, right in the path of the straight left hand from the southpaw. Watch again. He shouldn't be laying there. I talked about it earlier, Joe, exactly that. There was space. He was given space laying on the side. Watch again. He lays over on his left side with space, space for the right hand, or I should say the southpaw left hand, to be thrown and to connect. If you're going to lay over on the side, get close. Take that space away. Don't lay over on the side like that where you're right in the path of the punch. What you have to do is get close or weave your head back to the other side. He laid right over there in the alleyway of the power punch of Hayano.
Let's check in with Bernardo. Bernardo?
Just minutes ago, the doctor told me that he was unconscious. Fortunately, he's doing a lot better now, so the danger point seems to have passed. They want to take him out by ambulance, and it seems like Marone and his team do not want to use the ambulance. We'll see where this all ends up.
Let's make it official for Juan Carlos Payano.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Randy Newman calls a halt to this contest. The official time of the stoppage, 39 seconds into round number 7. Your winner by knockout and still undefeated from Santiago, Dominican Republic,